everyone, it's Jessica from the Bill Coors Wellness Center, and I have your WOD for the day. We have a little bit of everything in this workout. We're going to do a cardio HIIT, some lower body burn-in, and some core. So, before you do your cardio HIIT, be sure that you warm up. I linked one of Justin's full body mobility routines for Friday. Really great. Be sure you check it out. This part's going to be a little bit intense. So, we're going to do a run HIIT. We're going to do 1 minute walking, 45 seconds running at an easy to moderate pace, something that you can maintain, say, for a long time, 15 seconds all out sprint, and then you're gonna repeat that 5 times for a total of 10 minutes. If running's not your thing, you could also do that as a speed walk. So walk faster, walk even faster, and then keep on going through that. You could also do this on the bike, cruising along, you know, just about 60 to 80 RPMs, 80 to 100 RPMs, and then 100 plus, 1 to 120 or so, sprint. So different options that you could do that with. After that, we're gonna go into a strength routine for lower body burn. If you have weights, be sure to add those. We have 3 different sets, an A exercise and a B exercise. You're gonna do A exercise, B exercise, back and forth. 3 times, once you're done with that, you'll move on to set 2 and then set 3. So our first one, we have a squat reverse lunge. So squat, back to center, reverse lunge, squat, reverse lunge. 10 times or 5 reverse lunges on each side. After that, you're gonna hold in a stationary lunge, and my top foot is bent still. The bottom foot goes down and then straightens. So see how my leading leg is straight, back leg is straightening, squeezing the buns, 15 on each side. For set 2, we have a hinge or an RDL to a sumo squat. So feet are just a little bit wider than shoulder width apart. We hinge, staying really tight to our body. Drop our butt down for a squat, press up, and I'll show you from the side. Shoulder width apart, toes are slightly out in the corner. Hinge, drop the butt down, chest up high, press up through the feet. 10 of those, and then 10 side lunges on each side. Dropping down, this leg is straight. Weight is in this leg's heel, so we're leaning back slightly. Press the floor away, back to center, 10 of those on each side. On the mat for set 3, we have a glute bridge, 15 of these. Hands are down, if you have weights, your weights are gonna rest on your hips. Press straight up in the air, hold for a second, and back down. Make sure your core is strong with this as well. They go together. And then on your hands and knees in a tabletop position, we have fire hydrants. So my core is really strong again. I'm tucking my tailbone, not going like this, curving my tailbone inward and out to the side. You have 20 total of these on each side. If you have a small hand weight, like a 5, you could put it in between your hamstring and your knee and hold it up. Or if you have a band, you could put that right over your knee. Our last section is core. We have 3 moves, 45 seconds on, 15 seconds on twice, so 6 minutes. We're going to be in a plank position on your elbows. We have a plank reach, so I'm reaching forward, coming back down. You could also do this on your hands or on your knees. Flip it around for the second core move. We have leg extensions on our elbows. We press our legs out and in. If you want to make it harder, you go closer to the ground. You want to make it a little easier. Don't go out as far. Maybe a little bit higher. 45 seconds of that. Our last move is penguins. We're on the ground. Our hands are up to the side, our shoulder blades are up, we're looking towards our belly button. We lean towards the side, back to center, exhale, reach towards the side. Instead of reaching with your arms, make sure you're bending at your waist. That's really important to know. It's something that I see that people do wrong. If you bend at your waist, you're gonna get a little bit more core work out of it than reaching with your arms. That is your workout. Just a reminder that this was created for BCWC members and for Molson Coors employees. I will see you next week.